Interested in creating tables with Notion? It can be a great tool for data visualization and calculations, but there are some key differences from traditional spreadsheet softwares that are important to know. In this video, we'll be covering everything you need to know about simple tables and table view databases. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first start with how to create tables with Notion. So if you have an empty Notion page, you can go all the way to the bottom of the page where you have this Get Started With, and you can simply click Table. And this way you can do plus new table and basically create a brand new table database from scratch. Another option for creating tables in Notion is just by simply typing slash table view and click table view and plus new table. And this way you can create an inline table view database where you can also add additional things on the bottom part of your page and in other areas. Another thing you can do is add tables as a linked view database, and this is useful if you already have an existing table in Notion and all you have to do is type slash linked view of database and select the correct database that already is in table view. So in this case, tables in Notion, this one is already in table view. So you can easily add a linked view, and linked view just means that it is a linked view of the database. So any changes you make here is going to be reflected in the main database. The other thing we wanted to show is that any Notion database can be shown in different layouts. So if you click this three dots here and then go to layout, right now it's in table, but if you had a board view database, you can easily switch it into a table view. Now let's go over the basics and settings for tables in Notion. So when you have a table view database like this, basically each row is considered a page. So you can open it up and write things inside of the page, as well as add different properties. So in this case, every table entry acts as a page where you can store information. In terms of settings, you can go to the three dots here and check the layout settings here. So you can do things like toggle on or off vertical lines, wrap all columns, and choose how the pages are open, whether it's side peek, center peek, or full page. And you can also toggle on or off show page icon. So let's go ahead and cover properties inside of Notion tables. So if you want to add a property really easily, all you have to do is click this plus sign, and then you can choose any of these options. So let's say we wanted to add a number property, you can just click number like this. You have these options, whether or not you show it as a number, a bar, a ring, and various number formats. The other way you can add a property is by opening up one of the entries and clicking plus add a property. And then again, you can select any of these as you wish. You can also go to the three dots over here, go to properties, and click plus new property to add new properties. The other thing we wanted to show you is that you can easily hide properties from the main view. So if you didn't want to see this number property anymore, you can click it and then go to hide in view. And this is going to hide that property, but if you open it up, it's still going to be there. You can also do things like property visibility so that if you want to hide it when it's empty, always hide or always show, you can do things like that as well. Another quick trick we wanted to show you with table view is that if you have multiple properties that are here lining this up, so let's say that there's a number property here and we have further number properties like this, and it gets harder to see the name of your table view database as you have more and more, then you can actually just click here and freeze up to column so that you can always maintain the name on the left hand side. So let's say that we have more number properties. So then we can actually scroll like this so that you can always see the name of the page. So here are all the ways where you can add new entries to your tables in Notion. You can click plus new here to add a new row. You can also click here new and add a new row as well, and this is actually going to automatically also open up the page. If you have a cell selected like this, you can also type shift enter to add a new row like this as well. Another really important thing to know about Notion tables is this six dots on the left hand side of all the rows. If you click here, there are multiple options. So you can delete the row, duplicate the row, open it in a new tab, open a new window, open inside peek, copy link, rename, edit property, move to, add to favorites, and icons. So these are all the options that you have available to you when you click the six dots on the side, which can be a really easy way to edit the row. Another thing is that it's really easy to bulk edit Notion tables, which is one of the key features of this database type. So if you wanted to select them all, you can just hover here to the left hand side, click this and have all seven selected. And what you can do is have all these options. So you can sort of find a tag, you can delete all of them, you can copy links to all, edit a certain property. So if we wanted to edit the name, all of them to page one, you can do something like this. Another interesting thing with Notion tables is that you can add, for example, a tag here. And if you wanted to copy it across all of your rows, you can simply drag this down like this. So this is a really handy way to sort of bulk edit your Notion tables. Rearranging columns and rows are also very easy with Notion. You can drag like this in order to create the best width for you. You can also reorder by dragging a selected row like this if you don't have any kind of current sort in place. So one of the most useful features of Notion tables is the ability to calculate your columns. So let's go ahead and go back to the three dots here to properties and actually show the numbers. So we can show a number property like this. Let's say that we have some random numbers here, just as an example on how you can kind of use these features. So if we put some numbers, now we can actually go to the bottom of the row, click calculate. And you can calculate things like sum. So if we wanted to calculate the sum of all of these columns, you can do that. You can also find the average, median, min, max, and range. So all of these are super useful. You can also do things like percent empty or not empty. So if we just took out one of these like this and did percent empty, you can see how many of these rows are empty. And you can also do things like count values, unique values, and so on, as well as just none. And one of the other use cases for this that's super useful is if you put a checkbox property. So if we click the plus sign here and look for checkbox, and let's say that you have two checked out of this many, then you can go ahead and click calculate and percent checked. So this is also a really handy way to keep track of how many things you have checked off, which is particularly useful for things like habit trackers and also daily task lists. The next thing we wanted to show you is how to group inside of tables. And this is another really useful and handy thing to use inside of Notion tables. So let's say that we have different tags here. So we have tag 2 like this, and also a tag 1. So if this one is called tag 1, and we can change this one to 2. So basically, if you have two types of tags, you could go ahead and go to the three dots here, go to group and turn on tags. So now you can see all of your table items inside tag 1 and all of your table items inside of tag 2. So grouping is really useful. There's a lot of also settings here as well. You can manually sort, alphabetical sort, and you can choose to hide or not hide empty groups. You can also reorder your visible groups like this. So grouping can also be a really useful tool inside of Notion tables. Another thing you might want to do is to make sure to learn about the filter and sort features inside of Notion tables. So if you wanted to filter it by, let's say, checkbox, you can only show the ones that are checked or only show the ones that are unchecked. So these kind of filter settings can be really useful as you use tables in Notion. We, for example, like to have completed and incomplete tabs inside of our Notion tables to just show what items have been completed by the checkbox and what items have not been completed by the checkbox. Another thing that's useful is the sort features. If you wanted to sort by name, checkbox, number, tags, that can all be done. A particularly useful thing to do is to sort things by date. So if we added another date property here, you could actually go ahead and sort it by the date. So you can either choose ascending or descending and save for everyone. So another thing we wanted to show you is that you can search within your table for information. So if we go to the search feature here, you can, for example, type how to create tables, and immediately you see the correct results that you're looking for. So this is a really handy tool to find quick information that you're looking for. So if we wanted to find four, you find four from this, and it basically only shows the item relevant to the search query. So that's the basics of how to create database tables inside of Notion. If you're interested in having spreadsheet functionalities, unfortunately, Notion is lacking a bit in that part, and it's really important to understand in what way. So, for example, you can calculate columns very easily in this way, as you can see. And you can also add multiple number properties. So let's say we put another number property and we wanted to add sort of a formula that would calculate between the two number properties. You could do something like adding this number property and another number property, and then adding a formula that would actually add the number plus the number here. So then you can see here that it's actually adding up these two numbers like this. So in that sense, you can do stuff like that, that there is a calculation going on row wide. And then you can also add calculations going here. So you can do things like sum. But beyond that, if you wanted to actually treat a particular cell as a place to add a formula, that would be quite difficult and not possible at the moment. So in that case, you would need a spreadsheet, but it's just important to understand the difference between spreadsheet and also this kind of database structure. So another thing people often get confused by is, what is the difference between the database tables and a simple table? So if you type slash table, you basically have two choices, a table and a table view. If you just want a simple table, you can create one by clicking table. And what this does is basically gives you like a free form area to construct your table like this. You can change the color, for example, of a row by turning on header row, adding colors. So if you wanted like a brown background, you could do that. And you can put things like topic, some other kind of manual data if you want, or a way to actually categorize your information. So it could be like topic and description, topic one, and you can do description one like this. This is just like a free form way to add information into a table base structure. That's quite different from databases. As you can see, you cannot open this up or write further information here, but it's actually pretty convenient as well if you want to display a set information inside of an easy to understand table structure. Thank you so much for watching. We hope that this was helpful. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.